Hi, Miss.
Let's going to start with our class today. I'm going to tell your assistant first, and then let's going to start. Today we are going to have grammar, right? El día de hoy vamos a tener como la explicación de la gramática del día de hoy. And that will be like our last class, I think so, explaining. So remember that the next week we are going to have test or final test, and that will be everything for this year. Bueno, la siguiente semana ya estamos en evaluaciones finales y creo que pues ya hoy es la última clase de explicación. Viernes vamos a trabajar lectura y deletreo y that's all for this year. Y se acabó el año escolar y eso va a ser todo, ¿ok? Don't cry, please. You have to be brave. No se vale llorar, ¿ok? Entonces, vamos entonces. Tomo asistencia. Tengo a Esteban, a Natalie, Carlos y Jonathan. And who else? Vemos pues. Tengo a Emerson también. Mm-hmm. Tell me.
¿En qué va?
Yo ahorita entré.
Ok, Arlet. Muy bien. Estoy tomándoles asistencia. Ilse. And Andrea. Gaby. Who else? Rocío. Javes. And just that, right? Oh, Guillermo y Wells. ¿Alguien me falta? ¿O alguien no escuchó su nombre? Guillermo. Yes, I already take your assistance, Guillermo. Okay. Thank you so much. Let's go in, entonces, to start. Vamos a dar inicio con la clase del día de hoy. Was supposed to and was going to. Suena un poco extraño porque el was supposed to, ambos están en pasado, right? But el was going to era como el fue, ¿verdad? En pasado. Dice, we use was o were, ¿verdad? Dependiendo del pronombre en el que estemos utilizando. Recuerden que I, he, she, e it van a utilizar el was. Y you, we, you y they van a utilizar el were. Supposed to and was were going to talk about past plans and expectations and their past or future consequences. Dice que vamos a utilizar el was supposed to y el was going to para hablar acerca de planes y expectativas en el pasado y las consecuencias que tuvieron en el pasado o las consecuencias que tendrían en el futuro. Esto podríamos traducirlo como el se suponía, right? It was supposed to... We are going to be happy forever, right? Vamos entonces, se suponía que íbamos a ser felices para siempre, right? It was just a supposed.
¿Mis qué página es?
Estamos en la página 100, ahorita les digo. 129, exercise 6B. Este de acá. Página 129, 6B, ¿ok? We are talking about suppose. Okay, just give me a minute, please. Por ejemplo, ¿alguna expectativa que ustedes tuvieran en el año y que algo que ustedes hayan imaginado o que hayan suponido, creo que se dice? No, ¿supuesto? Oh, sorry, I didn't know how to say it in Spanish. Something that you supposed, because I don't know how to say it in Spanish. And that didn't happen. Y algo que no pasó. So, what was your expectations?
Nuestra graduación.
Ah, that could be a one.
En el colegio.
Ajá, las clases en el colegio, your graduation. What other? Have boyfriend or girlfriend, for example? You suppose
that. Mi fiesta de 15 años, Miss.
Ah, your 15th party, it could be an expectation too. Definitely it was just an expectation. Okay, it said, was supposed to means you were obligated to do something in the past, but you didn't or you won't. In other words, if you don't do something, you were supposed to. Somebody is probably going to be disappointed or get angry with you. Vean entonces, dice, cuando utilizamos el supposed to, se refiere a que estábamos como obligados a hacer algo, right? en el pasado. Y no lo hicimos o no lo vamos a hacer, right? En otras palabras, dice, quiere decir que si no lo hacemos, vamos a alguien probablemente se va a molestar y se va a enojar con nosotros. For example, you was supposed to send to me your homework complete, right? Se suponía que debían enviarme sus tareas completas. But that doesn't happen or that will not happen. Pero eso no pasó o no va a pasar. So I'm going to get mad with some of you, right? Y entonces es probable que vaya a molestarme con algunos de ustedes. Because it just was like a suppose, right? Porque era solo como un supuesto. O que se supone que ustedes deben hacerlo, pero probablemente no lo hagan o no lo vayan a hacer. And was going to tiene un similar significado, pero it has means of intention rather than an obligation. El was going es más como una intención que como una obligación, right? If I say, I was going to visit my best friend. Se suponía que iba a visitar a mi mejor amiga. It was just a supposed, right? But it was not my obligation, right? Era solo como que una suposición. No tenía nunca una obligación de hacerlo. Y si no lo hago, pues está bien, right? No pasa nada si no lo hago. Esa es la diferencia entre el was supposed to y el was going to, right? Remember, you can, we can use was or were en cualquiera de los dos casos. Entonces, el primero es como una obligación, algo que tendrían o se suponía que tenían que hacer. Y el segundo es como una intención. Y tenemos aquí algunos examples. In number one, say, I was supposed or I was going to join this weekend, but I won't because I have to work. Se suponía o se suponía, pero sí entendemos el significado entre los dos, right? Que este fin de semana me iba a unir con ustedes. But I won't because I have to work. Pero no lo voy a hacer porque tengo que trabajar. Si uso el I was supposed, era como mi obligación, right? I was supposed to join you this weekend. But I won't because I have to work. Se suponía que debía unirme con ustedes o reunirme con ustedes este fin de semana, pero no lo haré porque tengo que trabajar, right? Puede que se molesten porque no lo haré, o puede que alguien vaya a enojarse conmigo porque no lo haré. But if I say, I was going to join you this weekend, me iba a unir con ustedes este fin de semana, ¿ya? Era como una opción. Number two, we were supposed to hand in the report last Wednesday, but we couldn't, we had to, dice entre paréntesis, ¿verdad? Se suponía que teníamos que entregar los reportes el miércoles anterior, pero no pudimos. Pero aún tenemos que hacerlo, ¿right? Aún es como necesario terminarlo. Esta sí es una obligación. O you can say, I was going to buy some fresh fruit, but the supermarket was closed. I planned, dice, o sea, mis planes eran ir a comprar fruta fresca, pero el supermercado estaba cerrado. No pasa nada. ¿Verdad? Ya no está en mis posibilidades como solucionar que abran el supermercado para comprar la fruta, right? It is possible, it says, to use this expression in negative and in question forms. Sí es posible utilizarlos en forma negativa y en forma de pregunta. ¿Cómo lo hacemos en forma negativa? Just add el wasn't o weren't, a cualquiera de los dos, ¿verdad? Solo se supone que deben volver negativo el auxiliar, que en este caso es was o were, y that's all. And if you want to do an interrogative, you have to move the was at the beginning and add a question mark at the end of the sentence. I don't know. Do you have questions? Do you understand or not?
No, miss.
No questions? Okay. I would like that you think of something that you're supposed to do and that you use was supposed to or was going to. Vamos entonces, ahora a ustedes les voy a dar 30 segundos para que piensen en algo que se suponía que debían hacer. Pueden utilizar el was supposed to o el was going to, right? And then I'm going to ask to you, les voy a ir preguntando como al azar, right? While I'm going to move this. Mientras me voy a mover a los ejercicios ya del inicio. You have to think or you can think from the things that you supposed to do. Las cosas que se supone deberían hacer. Era lo que estábamos trabajando en estos ejercicios de acá. Was supposed to and was going to, right? Do you have it? ¿Los tienen? Are you ready? Did you think it? ¿En algo que se suponía que debían hacer y que no hicieron? ¿O en algo que se supone que deberían hacer como como una opción, digamos, en la que no tenían como tanta obligación, right? It said Buzzbox. Mientras van pensando, les comparto el Buzzbox. Was supposed to means you were obligated to do something in the past, but you didn't or you weren't. El was supposed to significa que estaban obligados a hacer algo en el pasado, but you didn't or you weren't. Que no lo hicieron o no lo harán. In other words, if you don't do something you were supposed to do, somebody is probably going to get disappointed or get angry with you. En otras palabras, esto significa que si no lo hacen, alguien probablemente se molestará o se enojará contigo o con ustedes. And was going to has a similar meaning with was supposed to. However, it has the meaning of intention rather than an obligation. Pero en este caso, dice que no tienen como que una obligación, sino como una suposición nada más. Okay, I'm going to give you an example. In the past, the woman was supposed to obey the man. The man, for example. En el pasado, se suponía o se trataba de que las mujeres obedecieran a los hombres, right? Now it doesn't happen more, right? Eso ya no pasa más. Bueno, sí pasa, pero ya no como una obligación, right? Sí, tienen que seguir obedeciendo y hay ciertas cosas que deben cumplir, pero ahora las mujeres tienen voz y voto, right? So, in the past, the woman was supposed to stay quiet, for example. En el pasado se suponía las mujeres debían estar calladas o en silencio, without opinion, without something, right? Or now, it was going to, women can do everything. Se supone que ahora las mujeres pueden hacer todo, right? Como una intención y ya no como una obligación. I don't know. Tell me, Jonathan, do you have your idea ready? ¿Tiene su suppose listo? ¿Puede compartirlo con nosotros, please?
Bueno. I was supposed going to buy things at the supermarket.
That's correct. Muy bien, correcto. I was going or I was supposed to. Recuérdense, el supposed to es como la obligación. Tienen que hacerlo porque no hay otra opción, right? Y el was going to es como la opción. Si quiero, lo hago, y si no lo hago, no hay ningún problema. Okay, Gaby Vanegas, can you share with us, please, yours?
I was supposed to be early in my English class.
That's correct. If you didn't stay, your teacher get mad, right? Y si no lo está, pues el teacher se queda como molesto. Okay, let's going to listen to Arlet. Arlet, do you have your suppose?
Yes. I was supposed to do my homework.
That's correct. Excellent. Natalie, can you share your suppose, please?
I was supposed I play with my brother.
And if you didn't do, your mom get mad with you, right? That's correct. Excellent. Y si no lo hace, su mamá se enoja. Correcto. Jose, can you share your suppose, please?
I was supposed to say drink water, to drink water.
Excellent, that's correct. But if you didn't do, you are going to get sick, right? Okay, excellent. Emerson, please suppose you share your suppose. Emerson, are you there paying attention or not? We can hear you, sorry.
Miss, dice Emerson que se le fue el audio, no sé por qué. Lo está arreglando okay. Por el momento.
Okay, thank you. Let's go with Andrea. Andrea, can you share your suppose, please?
I was supposed that I do clean my house.
Mm-hmm, that's correct. You was supposed to clean your house. Excellent. Esteban, can you share your suppose with us, please?
I was supposed to play football.
Mm-hmm. That's correct. Muy bien. Rocío, can you share your suppose? Is Rocío there?
Sí, Miss, aquí estoy. Disculpe.
Okay.
I was supposed to be at school today.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. If you didn't stay, you missed the point. That's correct.
Thank you.
Okay, what about Guillermo? Can you share your suppose?
I was supposed to the air out and the power.
Mm-hmm. Javes, can you share your suppose?
I was supposed to clean my bedroom.
Mm-hmm. And if you didn't do, your mom get mad, right? That's correct. Carlos, share your suppose, please.
I was going to be a play friend.
Mm-hmm.
Solo eso mismo.
Solo, just mm-hmm. that. Are you sure? Okay, thank you. Let's go with Ilse. Ilse, can you share your suppose?
Supposed to watch my class.
Uh-huh, that's correct. Muy bien. Who else? Who's missing? Natalie, I ask you, right? Brandon, can you share your suppose, please? I don't know, is Brandon there? If not, I'm going to ask to Gaby. Marroquín, can you share your suppose, please?
I was supposed to clean the bathroom.
Okay, that's correct. Excellent. So, I don't know. Do you have questions how to use it? No sé, preguntas o dudas sobre cómo utilizarlo? O cómo se supone how it was supposed to do it?
No, miss.
No? Okay. So, if you don't have questions, I think that this will be everything for today because I have to explain it to you today, this, and I'm going to work with you the part of the reading, okay? Solo vamos a movernos a la parte del reading para que ustedes puedan entender y sepan cómo hacer del writing, perdón, cómo hacer su columna del periódico, porque sí tienen una tarea con respecto a esta, right? It says three teenagers arrested in Clopton armed robbery. Tres adolescentes arrestados en un robo armado en Clopton. Okay? So let's going to start and I'm going to ask to Guillermo that read the first sentence, please. I don't know, can you watch correctly?
¿Qué manda?
¿Puede por favor leer la primera oración? Three teenagers arrested in Compton desde 3 hasta Monday.
Three teenagers were arrested by Clopton County police on the Monday.
On a Monday, that's correct. Continue, Esteban, please, to the next point.
They were, ¿cómo se dice eso?
Church
with robbing an old woman last Tuesday near the pumpkin park around 7 p.m.
That's correct. Let's going to continue, Gaby Vanegas.
¿Y solo se quedaron? Me perdí.
The old woman?
The old woman, Janice Grayling,
was taking a break sitting on the bench in the park with her groceries when three teenagers came up to her and started a conversation.
Okay, that's correct. Thank you. Continue, please. Carlos.
She did some, didn't send any help.
Bad?
Bad intentions. Intention. It forced.
At first?
They forced. So she
talked.
Talk with them.
That's correct. Continue, Jonathan, please.
Later, one of the teenagers asked what she had bought from the supermarket.
That's correct. Excellent. Let's go into continue with Ilse, please.
Why? The teenager questioned one of the others who came behind here and held her neck while the others took what they wanted from the bath.
Thank you, just that. Thank you, just that. All of her money. Let's go into continue with Javis, please. How do you say 300? 300 se dice 300.
¿Por dónde se habían quedado?
Mis? Aquí, en 300. $300.
$300 from the first father on the police station. Janice identified the teenagers as the culprits of the ¿cómo se dice eso?
Assault
on robbery.
Thank you so much. And finish, please, Arlet. Finish the reading, please. Their names are, just the last part, Arlet, please.
Their names are Julianne Desher, 16th, Charlize Riefendel, 17th, Maria Tunkerwell, 15th.
Okay, thank you so much. I don't know, do you have questions about some words that you didn't understand there? No sé, alguna palabra que no hayan entendido de lo que leímos aquí?
Miss, what is culprit?
Culprits, culpables. It's like an British version, I think so. Es como una versión en el inglés británico. Remember that we have American and British English, right? So, in the American, you can say blamer, culpable. But in the British, you can say culpist. Okay, another one.
Teenagers.
Adolescentes. Another one?
Later.
Later, después.
Neck, miss.
Neck, cuello.
Came up.
Sorry?
Came up.
Came up, aparecer. O salir.
Words.
Words, peor, creo. O no, purse, P-U-R-S-E. Bolsa. O monedero. You can say the purse like la billetera o la cartera, el monedero, podríamos decir. Another one.
Purse.
Okay, vamos entonces. Purse dijimos que era bolsa. Okay. Another one. Bueno, vamos entonces. Dice, 15 teenagers were arrested by Clampton County Police on Monday. I would like that you use your imagination porque cuando lo estaban leyendo yo iba ahí como usando mi imaginación. Dice, tres adolescentes fueron arrestados por el departamento de policía de Clopton, el lunes. They were charged with robbing an old woman last Thursday near the pumpkin park around 7 p.m. Dice, fueron acusados o recibieron el cargo de robo hacia una mujer mayor el pasado jueves cerca del parque Pumpkin alrededor de las 7 de la noche. The old woman, Janice Granlin, was taking a break sitting on the bench in the park with her groceries when three teenagers came up to her and started a conversation. La anciana, o la mujer mayor, Janice Granlin, estaba tomando un descanso sentada en la banca del parque con sus, no sus groserías, ¿verdad? Sino con sus, ¿cómo? How do you say it? Como con sus compras o algo. Las groceries son como los artículos de primera instancia, right? Café, azúcar, o la canasta básica, que podríamos decir en Spanish. So, he was with her groceries, and when three teenagers came up to her and started a conversation, cuando tres adolescentes aparecieron, e iniciaron una conversación. She didn't sense any bad intention at first, so she talked with them. No sintió ninguna mala intención al inicio, así que ella habló con ellos. Later on, mucho después, one of the teenagers asked her what she had bought from the supermarket. Luego, uno de los adolescentes le preguntó qué había comprado del supermercado. While she was answering the teenager's question, one of the other two came behind her and held her neck while the others took what they wanted from all the bags and from all the money. Dice, uno de los otros dos salió hacia de la parte de atrás de ella y la tomó por el cuello. Right? Can you imagine that? La pobre ancianita ahí luchando, ¿verdad? Por sus propias fuerzas. Y mientras ella iba respondiendo a las preguntas, uno la sostuvo y los otros dos, dice, tomaron todo lo que quisieron de las bolsas. And all of her money, y todo su dinero. $3,000 from her purse, $300 de su monedero. Later at the police station, luego en la estación de policías, Janice identified the teenagers as the culprits of the assault and robbery. Janice identificó a los adolescentes como culpables de asalto y robo. Vean, el asalto es como cuando a alguien le roban, pero solo le dice, deme todo su dinero, right? There's don't have weapons, aquí no hay armas. But the robbery, they have weapons, right? Esa es como la diferencia entre el asalto y el robo en estos casos. En el asalto, solo es como la amenaza, right? Y en el robbery, ahí sí, utilizan armas y todo. Their names are Gillian Dasher, 16, Charles Refendel, 17, and Maria Turkey-Wall, 15. Tres adolescentes de 16, 17 y 15 fueron arrestados. So, remember that with the information that you have in your brochure, con la información que tienen en su folleto, deben tratar de hacer algo similar a este párrafo que acabamos de ver, ¿ok? Do you have questions about that?
No, Miss Topher.
Okay, thank you so much. If you don't have questions, that will be everything for today. Si no tenemos entonces preguntas o dudas, gracias. That will be everything for today. And I hope to see you on Friday. Remember, Friday will be our last class. El viernes es nuestra última clase. The next week we are going to be on final test, vamos ya a estar en evaluaciones finales, entonces, you have to study, please, try to study, we are going to have lesson 6A and 6B, ok, solo vamos a tener las lecciones 6A y 6B para que no se carguen, right? So, questions? No questions? No? Ok, thank you guys for coming today's class and I hope to see you next. Have a nice day and enjoy your day. Bye guys.
Bye, Mitch.